Good afternoon, students.
Good afternoon, sir.
Yeah. Can you hear my voice?
Yes, sir.
Okay, right. So, before going to the today's concept about the Roman civilization, we had certain discussion over the last class regarding the daily life and the life in the countryside, in the villages are like that. Okay, so as a part of the cultural aspect, we are discussing one by one. Okay, before that, we had a discussion over literature, then religion, mythology, and in the last class we had a discussion over the daily life, the life of the people, and the life particularly in the countryside, and also about the clothing, all those things. Okay, so today we are going to see the other remaining things as a part of cultural aspects of Roman civilization. Okay, so students, before going to my discussion, I have to share my screen. Students, are you getting my screen?
Yes, sir.
Today we'll see the life in the city. Then we'll move to the housing and homes, and we'll discuss about art and architecture. Okay. So first of all, we'll see the life in the city, and you are well aware that the whole Roman society is confined with the urban centers and the trade centers, and also you have certain modern concepts like the drainage system, sewerage, and hygienic. Okay, so you are well aware that these Romans were the people who followed certain hygienic conditions in the ancient times. Okay, so not only that, they are aware about certain diseases, and for the cure, those for treatment of those diseases, they followed certain precautions also. Okay, so and such cleanliness and hygiene they followed, and they had a awareness over the a systematic urban life in their society also. Okay, so in the systematic urban life, they constructed a planned structures, particularly the buildings, and also public baths are like that. Okay, so we'll see what are the things they followed in the urban areas, and then we'll move to their dwellings, how their dwellings are there, from which material they constructed certain dwellings are like that. Okay, so first of all, we'll see the life in the city, and the hub of the life in ancient Rome was the city, and the local city was the place to trade goods, be entertained, and meet important people. While Rome was the center of the empire, and there were many large and important cities throughout the empire. Okay, so we see nearly 10 to 12 provinces in the all over the Roman civilization, and each province has had one or two cities like that. Okay, so and every province and every city had the well connected with the Rome. Rome is the main city, which is Rome is well connected with all provinces and towns with roadways at that time. Okay, so first of all, we'll see the city planning, and the Romans built cities through their vast empire. And when they built a new city, they typically used the same type of city plans, and the streets were straight and on a grid. Okay, so like the system of town planning in the Indus Valley, such similar similar conditions you will see in the life of the ancient Romans. Okay, so through the center of the town were the two widest streets which went east to west and north to south. And at the center of the town was the Forum with the government buildings, temples, markets, and which is a market meeting area. Okay, so surrounding the town was a tall fortified wall to help keep out the invaders. And these walls were specially important for the towns near the borders of the empire. And aqueducts were built outside of the town to bring fresh water to the fountains and public baths. Okay, so in the as a part of the city planning, they constructed certain aqueducts and fountains and public baths. Okay, so aqueducts were certain water channels which they are connected with the domestic domestic places with the certain lakes or reservoirs which adjoining to certain towns and cities. Okay, so those were the fresh water channels which is carried from the outside of the city, right? So when you see the forum also another important concept in the ancient Roman life, and the most important area of every Roman city was the Forum. And the Forum was the center of the local government and the main marketplace for the city. Okay, so it's a public place where the market for various commodities were available, which supposed to be at the center of the city. And it was at the Forum where politicians would give speeches when they were up for the elections. Okay, so such a modern way, they also followed such things. These are like public places where the leaders, like various groups, they can speak with the people directly. Okay, so those are like those are the place where they arrange the public speeches by the various leaders or the government officials. And another one is the commerce. The city is served as a central point for the commerce. Farmers would bring their products into the city to trade for other goods or coins. Okay, so you are well aware that they followed in the initial days, there is a system of barter where these things were exchanged with the needy. Okay, so such a system they followed. Okay, so in the Forum there was generally a table where standard weights and measures could be verified. Okay, so in the Forum they kept a table of the prices are like that. Okay, so everyone can easily get those prices and they can easily buy and sell also. Okay, so following such an standard weights and measures, and this kept people from being cheated when doing business. Okay, so they can avoid the corruption or cheating by various sellers or buyers. Okay, so housing system, there were two main types of housing in the cities. the poor and middle class people in large apartments or buildings called insale. Okay, so insale is such a place where you see a structure like the modern type of apartment. Okay, so where the people which combinedly live at a single place is nothing but the insale, right? Though majority of the people lived in insale, and the wealthy lived in their private homes, and we can see certain homes in the separately in the Roman homes. Okay, so when you see the entertainment, large Roman cities all had some public buildings for entertainment, and these included an outdoor amphitheater. Amphitheater is nothing but a open air theater. Okay, so events like gladiator fights are like taken place. These amphitheaters provided seating for nearly 50,000 also. Okay, and also a circus used for chariot races, and a theater and the public bus. Okay, so all these public places which provide the entertainment to the people. And such public baths also, keeping clean was important to Romans living in the city. Any large Roman city had public baths, and where people could go to the bath. And bathing was a popular pastime for the Romans. They would hang out with their friends and even hold business meetings at the bathhouses only. Okay, so and such a similar thing we'll see in the Indus Valley civilization as a form of the Great Bath. Okay, so and the Roman was the largest of the all cities, and historians estimated that population of Rome may have reached up to 1 million people at that time. Okay, so other major cities such as the Alexandria, Ephesus, Carthage, and Antioch and had a peak population of nearly 2 lakh or more. Okay, so these are certain things about the city life. And again, I will move to particularly certain important things you find in the cities and rural areas, like housing and homes. Okay, so we'll have a glance over these homes and houses, and then we'll move to certain important places or the public places in the ancient Rome. Okay, so the Romans lived in a wide variety of homes, depending on whether they were wealthy or the poor. And the poor lived in a cramped apartments in the cities or in a small shacks in the country. And the rich lived in a private homes in the city or large villas in the countries. Okay, so in the yesterday's class, we had a discussion over certain villas are like that. Okay, so where these are the rich class were maintained such villas in the middle of particular lands. Okay, so like the landlords or any rich class, they separately construct a farmhouse like houses in between their lands. Okay, so in the for every 10 or 1 week days, they will visit these villas and spend their time very leisurely, and then return to their homes in the towns and cities. Okay, so such a modern phenomena which we get from this ancient Rome itself. Okay, so and when you see about the city, there are cities are like important things where everything you will get. Okay, so in the cities and towns were the common places, and those will provide you everything. Okay, so in that places, these cities and towns, which is like a center of attraction for the trade and commerce, and also for a urban life, and also a luxurious life, and many you get many things from this ancient cities of the Rome. Okay, so most people in the cities of ancient Rome lived in apartments called insulae. We already discussed, and the wealthy lived in single family homes called the domus, of various sizes depending on how rich they were. Okay, so we'll see the insulae. The vast majority of the people living in the Roman cities lived in the cramped apartment buildings called insulae, and insulae were generally 3 to 5 stories high and housed for 30 to 50 people they can live. Okay, so the individual apartments usually consisted of 2 small rooms also. Okay, so and the bottom floor of the insulae often housed shops. Okay, so in the ground floor of the apartments, they can give to such a merchants or trading class, for a rent. Those merchant class and trading class used those as a shops. Okay, so which is these apartments, this type structure you will see in the modern times also. Okay, so the bottom floor of the insulae often housed shops and stores that opened out to the streets. Okay, so the larger apartments were also near the bottom with the smallest at the top, and many insulae were not constructed very well. They could be dangerous places if they caught fire and sometimes even the collapse. Okay, so when you see the private homes, the wealthy elite lived in large single family homes called the domus, and these homes were much nicer than insulae, and most Roman houses had similar features and rooms, and there was an entry way that led to the main area of the house called the atrium. Okay, so other rooms such as the bedrooms, dining room and kitchen might be off to the sides of the atrium, and beyond the atrium was the office. In the back of the home was often an open garden. Okay, so you are watching the structure on the screen. Okay, so here are some of the rooms in the typical Roman house. One is the vestibulum, a grand entrance hall to the house. On either side of the entrance hall might be rooms that housed small shops opening out to the street. Okay, so this is called as the vestibulum. And atrium, an open room where guests were greeted. And the atrium typically had an open roof and a small pool that was used to collect water. Okay, so it is like a veranda which is adjoining with certain facilities. And tablinum is the office or living room for the man of the house. Okay, so the room which is used for the elder of that house. Okay, so and next one is the triclinium, the dining room. This was often the most impressive and decorated room of the house in the order to impress guests that were dining over. Okay, so other one is the cubiculum, the bedroom, and culina, the kitchen, right? So such important divisions you will see in the houses of in the ancient Roman Empire. Okay, so and when you see the homes in the country, and while the poor and the slaves lived in the small shacks or cottages in the countryside, and the wealthy lived in a large expansive homes called the villas. Okay, so when we have a glance over the villas also, and the Roman villa of wealthy Roman family was often much larger and more comfortable than their city home. They had multiple rooms, including servants' quarters, courtyards, baths, pools, storage rooms, exercise rooms, and gardens are like that. Okay, so they also had modern comforts such as the indoor plumbing and heated floors are like that. Okay, so such luxurious things they followed in the ancient houses and homes of the Roman civilization. Okay, so after that, we'll have certain important cities and towns, and we just see about the city of the Rome, and we'll close it, and then we'll move to art and architecture. Okay, so we'll see about the only the structure of the city Rome, ancient Rome, and then we'll close it, and then we'll go to the art and architecture tomorrow's class. Okay, so the city of the Rome was the capital of the city, whole civilization of ancient Rome, and it was located near the west coast of the central Italy, and the Rome is the capital of the country of Italy at present, and the city started out as small but grew as the empire, empire, and at one point there were over 1 million people living in the city during the ancient times, and the city was the center of power in the world for over 1,000 years or like that. Okay, so when you see the Roman roads, many major Roman roads led to the city of Rome. The Latin name for road was via. Via is, we are still using the term in the modern times also. Okay, so the Latin name for road was via, and the major roads leading to Rome included the Via Appia. Okay, so the Via Aurelia, and the Via Cassia, and the Via Salaria. Okay, so such roads we'll see. And inside the city itself, there were also many paved streets. Okay, so within the city, the whole city was divided into certain streets or the lanes like that. Okay, so when you see the water for the Rome city, water was brought into the city by the use of several aqueducts. Aqueducts are nothing but the water carrying channels. Okay, so through the pipelines are like that. Okay, so these channels are commonly used for the up to the low, like mountainous to the lower part of the mountains. And sometimes these are used from the lakes, which is lakes and reservoirs, which is outside the towns and cities. From those reservoirs, they can provide the water to the cities like that. Okay, so such a arrangements they followed during the ancient Rome. Okay, so water was brought into the city by the use of several aqueducts, and some of the wealthy had running water in their houses, while the rest of the people got their water from the fountains placed around the city also. Okay, so for the beautification, we are using the fountains in the modern concept. For the water, for usage of the water, the these fountains were they constructed in these Roman cities in the ancient days. Okay, so there were also many public bath houses that were used to bath and to socialize also. Okay, so it's like a great bath in the Indus Valley, where the public can take bath freely. Okay, so during the time of certain occasions or festivals also, these public people can take bath openly in the public. Okay, when you see the founding of the Rome, we had a certain things of the founding of the Rome while having a mythological stories. Okay, so according to certain mythological stories, Romulus and Remo, two brothers who were constructed the Roman city, the Rome, in 753 BC on the Palatine Hill, which is on the bank of River Tiber. Okay, so and according to another mythology, a woman, Remo, who supported the construction of the Rome on the bank of the River Tiber. Okay, such mythological stories we have already discussed. Okay, so and Roman mythology had Rome was founded by the half god twins Romulus and Remus on April 21st 753 BC, and Romulus was killed, removed to become the king, first king of the Rome, and the city was named after him. Okay, so this is the history of the history of foundation of the Rome, and which is constructed on the hill of the Palatine Hill, which is better to be called as the Seven Hills. Okay, so the city of the ancient Rome was built on the seven hills. One is Aventine Hill, Caslian Hill, and Capitoline Hill, Esquilian Hill, and Palatine Hill, and Quirinal Hill, and Viminal Hill. Okay, so these were the series of hills, and among these seven hills, the Rome was built on the Palatine Hill. Okay, so it is said that the original city was founded by Romulus on the Palatine Hill. And when you see the forum in the city Rome, at the center of the city, and the Roman public was the forum, and there was a rectangular plaza surrounded by the public buildings such as the temples of the gods and basilicas, where commerce and other public functions could take place. And many of the city's major events took place in the forum, such as elections and public speeches and trials and triumphal processions also. Okay, so you are watching a Roman forum, which is in the center of the city, Rome. Okay, so and when you see certain important buildings in and around this forum and as a part of the Rome, city Rome, the first one is the Regia, a place where the original kings of the Rome lived, and later it became the office for the head of the Roman priesthood, the Pontifex Maximus. Okay, so it is a place for this Roman priesthood. And the next one is the Comitium, the main meeting place for the assembly and the center of the politics and judicial activity in the Rome. It's nothing but the Comitium. Next one is the Temple of Caesar, the main temple where Julius Caesar was honored after his death. And next one is the Temple of Saturn, the temple to the god of agriculture, is nothing but the Saturn temple. Next one is Tabularium, the main records office for ancient Rome. And next one is the Rostra, a platform where people could make speeches. And Senate Curia, the place where the Senate was met. And next one is the Arch of Septimius Severus, a giant triumphal arch you'll see in the city of the Rome. Okay, so in the later years, the forum would become so crowded with people and buildings that many important functions had to move to other areas of the cities. When you see the other buildings, the center of the Rome had many other famous and important buildings like the Temple of the Jupiter, the Colosseum, the Circus Maximus, and the Pantheon, the Pompeius Theater, are like that. Okay, so you can see the dome of the Pantheon in the Rome, which is the it's like a dome where you see in the Indo Sarsanic architecture also. Okay, so such a dome you can observe in the building of Arts College of Usmania University, such a type of building which is somewhat similar to such architecture. Okay, so and when you see the many of the this government buildings and the homes of the rich were constructed of stone, concrete, and marble. Okay, so however, homes of the poor were made from wood, and these homes caused a considerable fire danger, and Rome had many terrible fires throughout its history. Okay, during the time of Nero also, you had a certain fire accident, and the half of the city was destroyed. Okay, so these are certain things about the city of the Rome, and about the city life and structures in the city, and particularly the planning of city and towns you'll see in the ancient Roman civilization. Okay, so dear students, this is end of my class regarding the city life or the urban life in the ancient Roman civilization. Okay, so tomorrow we'll complete we are going to complete this art and architecture, and then we'll move to science and technology. Okay, so dear students, thank you very much. This is end of my class. Regarding any doubts or clarification, now you are welcome to ask. Students, are you listening?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, so this is end of my class. Chapandi. Okay, right. So thank you. I am ending my class now. I will meet you tomorrow again at the same time.